Hello, guitarist Miles Okazaki here. This is a video to go along with a book I wrote called Fundamentals of Guitar. So there's a section near the beginning of the book dealing with pentatonics. And it's the beginning of organizing tonal information on the guitar, like where are all the pitches, where are all the notes, how do I kind of begin to think about, remembering where they all are, or organizing them in my mind or something like that. I'm always looking for kind of simple solutions and elegant solutions. And one of them seems to just be dealing with the way the guitar is tuned. E-A-D-G-B-E, which is a pentatonic scale, right? And in standard tuning, that is, you know. And this tuning is like a container that everything goes into. This tuning creates, as you go up the neck and you move around, there's shapes that are formed by pentatonics that everything kind of flows through, you know. And I found that if you kind of have a good feeling for these shapes, it can help out in more complex structures and scales with more notes and all kinds of things. It's kind of like a foundation, you know, the pentatonic thing. So I want to take a little closer look at that, you know. So we got this. This minor pentatonic scale that people learn when they first pick up the guitar, right? Down here in open position. These are still the same notes, E, A, D, G, B. They're just put in different order, right? You got E, G, A, B, D, E, G, A, B, D, E, G, you know, and so on. Now let's say, Let's say that I had figured that out. Okay, I've got my guitar, but I've never been up here, maybe. So I wanna explore, you know, what's up here. How do I find those pitches in other places? You know, I could just kind of pick them out. Okay. Okay, those sound pretty much like the same pitches, right? So now I'm playing the pentatonic scale from the root. I could keep going up, same type of thing. From the second degree, from the third degree. From the fifth degree. From the sixth degree. From the first degree again. From the second degree again. Space. So some of them started repeating. You saw it started repeating, right? So if I were to explore that for a while, I would say, okay, now I see there's only five different things because there's only five pitches in the scale, right? I mean, it seems kind of obvious, but I'll say it anyway. So there's five, like we call them modes or whatever. I like to think of them as like places that you can be in, you know, like areas, or in the book I call them regions. Like this region. It has a certain feeling to it, you'd call it a certain vibe, right? So, and it also has a certain kind of physical, tactile shape to it, you know, when you're with your fingers, that you can start to memorize and start to get the feeling for that region, right? The second one. Well, even though it's the same pitches, it has a much different feeling. This is a very uniform thing at the bottom. And then this more spread out thing at the top. So it just gives you a different feeling when you're there, you know? Where the root is has an effect on it, right? Up here, where different notes are, which strings they're on, gives it a different feeling. So anyway, you might explore each of those a little bit, you know, or a lot, whatever, and until they start to sink in, right? And whatever, you know, however, whatever way that you do that kind of thing, it might be through patterns. It this kind of thing, or, you know, whatever it is. But I like to kind of meander around or kind of improvise through it, you know. Might try to go. I'm just going to move between the first and second. Until those two start to kind of melt together into one thing, right? And I can just keep moving up, you know. Until the whole thing starts to feel like one thing. Like one map of the key of G, right? And then, you know, maybe I can just improvise and mess around all over the neck, but just try and stay with those five pitches. You know, like... Seeing if I can still hit the pitches without making too many mistakes, you know. And so that's the idea with that. Now, after that, I might say, well, okay, that's cool. I'm kind of getting tired of G major, you know. Let me see if I can move through some different keys, you know. Modulate. Modulate involves taking this whole picture that you have and shifting it on the guitar this way or that way, right? So let's say, one thing to do could be maybe go through circle of fifths, right? Here I am in G. Now maybe I want to go to C. Okay, now I'm still starting on the note G. I'm just starting from the, now I'm playing from the fifth of the key rather than the root. Now I'll go to F. Playing from the second degree of the scale, right? B flat. Playing from the sixth, right? E flat, playing from the third. Right? And then A flat. D flat. G flat. B. E. A. D. And then back to G, right? But now I'm in the next region. Look at that, I'm in the second region. So what that means is, as I've played 12 keys in the one region of the guitar, you know, which is nice. That means you can get through all 12 keys in the one region. And in each of these five regions, you have 12 keys, and that makes 60 modes, 60 different ways to express a pentatonic scale in a 12 fret area, right? And if you, you know, if you have 24 frets, then you have maybe 120 ways, I don't know. But, all right, so you practice these pentatonics, and you might say, what's the next step? Let me expand this a little bit. So, you know, you could take it to diatonic scales pretty quickly, you know. So you could say, well, to get from pentatonic to diatonic, just add those two notes, right, the fourth and the seventh. Or you could say, you could think about it in terms of how they're made. Like, if G pentatonic is is stacked fifth, G, D, A, E, B, right? You stack those fifths to get that scale, to create that scale. And you just add another fifth on top of the B, you get F sharp, and you add another fifth below the G, and you get C. C, G, D, A, E, B, F sharp. And you got seven notes, you got your G major scale, right? And then the top note of the chain, the B, and the F sharp, and the bottom note, the C, those are a tritone apart, right? So you have that. This tritone plus this, right, gives you your major scale, right, and diatonic scale. And then you have, you got your five positions, the five regions, and in each of those regions you have a major scale. You just add those two notes, right? You get your five diatonic modes. And people would say, well, there's seven. Aren't there seven diatonic modes? Because there's seven notes in the diatonic scale. So you start on each note and you get a different mode, right? Which is, that's true. that's true. I mean, that's true in theory and all that. But I'm talking more about in practice on the guitar, the physical sort of, the way the way that things are laid out from this pentatonic perspective. So if you're thinking about this position, right, and you add those two notes, then what you have is you're starting on an F sharp, right? And people would say, well, that's Locrian. But if you want Ionian, you just start on the G, and it's all in the same position. You know, it's all in the same physical position. So, I mean, you could just, it's not physically different, so I just think of it as one thing. It's just like the notes of G major that are in that area, right? So then, the second region, this thing, you add the C, F sharp, you get, Dorian, right? The third region, add C and F sharp, this is the same situation as in the first position. You start on B, you have Phrygian. You start on C, you have Lydian. Right? Either case, it's the same. It's the same position, so it doesn't make a difference. We call it Phrygian-Lydian. So yeah, you got Locrian-Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian-Lydian, then the next one, Mixolydian, right? The pentatonic skeleton of that is, when you're adding C and F sharp, you get, right? Then the last one, the C and F sharp, you get a Aeolian minor, right? Natural minor. So those are your, five diatonic modes that you could derive from the pentatonic. And you can see, like, now we could run those through the same stuff we did the pentatonics through. Like, we can go through the circle of fifths, for example. So what I'm doing here, I'm going through, in order to make it better, maybe I'll sing the root. Oh, and you'll hear the circle of fifths going through. La, apologies in advance. Right. Oh. Right, so I went through 12 keys. Sorry about the singing. And then, but you know, you get the idea. And then, again, I ended up on the Dorian. Ended up on the Dorian, on A Dorian, which is G major, right? So I went through the 12 keys in that one position, but this time just using the major scales. You know, and you could do that with any kind of scale, you know, but I'm using the major scale because that's you can very clearly see the underlying pentatonic thing there. So anyway, this is kind of a long video, but I hope it was useful. And there's much, much more in this book. I was just trying to go through. That was like 16, 17, 18, those pages in the book. That's around what I was talking about. So if you thought it was interesting, you know, check out the book. Check out some more of these videos. And thanks for watching. All right.